To all of you. Today we are celebrating the 75th year of independence of our country. Greetings for a very happy Independence Day. We, the people of India, feel the pride of being citizens of a free nation. We gratefully remember our freedom fighters and martyrs whose sacrifices have enabled us to live in an independent nation. The ethos of our freedom struggle forms the foundation of modern India. Our visionary leaders brought together a diversity of worldviews to forge a common national spirit. They were committed to the cause of liberating India from oppressive colonial rule and securing the future of India's children. Their thoughts and actions shaped the identity of India as a modern nation. The celebrations of Independence Day this year will be rather restrained. The reason is obvious. The whole world confronts a pandemic that has disrupted all activities and taken a huge toll. It has altered the world we lived in before the pandemic. The invisible pathogen has demolished the illusion that human being is the master of nature. The second lesson is that we are all equal before Mother Nature, and we primarily depend on our fellow citizens for survival and growth. Our fellow citizens, especially at a low income level and daily wage earners, are the worst hit by the pandemic. In this scenario, we, especially the Kerala Agriculture University community, have got greater responsibility compared to a common man to dedicate ourselves in our duty for the progress of the nation. Being a premier institution of teaching, research and extension in agriculture, we move forward as a community together. We recently bagged the Chancellor's Award 2020 for the first time under the specialized university category constituted by Honorable Governor of Kerala and the Chancellor of Kerala Agriculture University. We also improved our ICAR All India ranking to 19th position. We also obtained ICAR accreditation to all our colleges, and nearly more than 90 UG, PG and PhD programs continuously for 5 years till 2024. Our students, as usual, excelled in competitive exams at the All India level. In 2020, 127 students of Kerala Agricultural University qualified ICAR JRF and 56 students qualified ICAR SRF. Many students got selected for IIMs and many got selected for higher studies abroad, including joint PhD in the University of Western Sydney. In the light of the COVID-19 pandemic induced imposed restrictions, Kerala Agricultural University was the first university in the state to develop a dedicated learning management system, KAU Moodle, to continue its academic activities uninterruptedly. The university elevated ACER as a College of Climate Change and Environmental Sciences in Vellarikara. A Center of Excellence in Vegetables and Floriculture is being established in RARS Ambalavel with the technical support from Netherlands and financial support from state government and central government through state particle services. In line with the ICAR recommendation, 4-year duration B.Tech Biotechnology and B.Sc. Honours Climate Change and Environmental Sciences have started. KAU has also made the No to Dowry declaration mandatory by the students before issuing degree or diploma certificates. We could release 12 new crop varieties cutting across rice, coconut, vegetables and spices. Also, targeted programs are initiated to rejuvenate ecologically fragile systems of food production such as iPod and Kutada. The multi-grain Nutribar, developed under the Sampusta Kerala program and distributed through the Social Welfare Department, was popular among children both as a nutritional supplement and immunity booster. Significant milestones was achieved by the IPR cell of the university, which was successful in making Kerala the leading state in the country with respect to GI registrations and also in the number of plant genome saver awards facilitated for the farmers of the state. The PMFME and MSME programs are also initiated facilitating entrepreneurship development and value addition. Gene bank establishment and the seed bank project helps to conserve around 50,000 indigenous seeds of various crops for more than 30 years. Laboratory for assessing the quality of honey and the techno incubation center for processing and value addition are established in Vellayani. Operation Double Core has brought 3,000 hectares under the second crop of rice in the coal lands of Trichur in the first pilot study itself. Production and supply of quality planting materials and agriculture inputs, especially biocontrol agents, are another area in which KIU community has made a significant contribution. Around 230 tons of seeds, 69 lakhs of planting materials, and 300 tons of biocontrol inputs were distributed through various centers of the university in the last year. The patents received for innovations in agricultural machinery, such as weed wiper, Pokali harvester, and the recent one by our scientist at KCIT Thavanur, needs special mention. Departments in nanotechnology, remote sensing and geographical information system, organic farming are also started during the last year. KIU Raptor Agri Business Incubator has initiated its third cohort for startups in agriculture. The first and the second cohorts have resulted in getting seed stage funding and pre-seed stage funding for startups to the tune of about 2 crores from the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Government of India. Center of Advanced Agriculture Science and Technology Project, with the support of World Bank funded National Agriculture Higher Education Program of Indian Council of Agriculture Research, also delivers its milestones as per the time schedule. Directorate of Extension is the regional coordinating institute for the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan program by the Ministry of Human Resource Development. The Center of E-Learning has launched many new online and MOOC programs which aim at generating a newfound affinity towards agriculture and allied activities among the distant aspirants. The GKMS Vikra project has helped to connect with farmers through regular messages. Being a part of KDISC program and the Young Innovation Challenge, KU made it our presence prominent among the budding innovators. KU took the leadership to establish the block level agriculture knowledge centers in all the 150 blocks of the state. The AKCs are block level entities to disseminate state of the art knowledge in agriculture and allied sectors to farmers and development personnel to facilitate agriculture production at the grassroots. The establishment of AKCs assumes much importance in the backdrop of the delineation of distinct agroecological zones and agrometeorological units in the state. In the pandemic period, the role played by our Krishi Vinyan Kendras and the Directorate of Extension need special mention. Bittuvandi helped the farmers to get seeds for their agriculture operations in time. The series of online training programs on various topics helped the farmers update their knowledge. The farmer scientist interaction program and also help desk were yet another intervention that gained wider acceptance. The crop loss caused by vagaries of nature is another challenge we have to confront. The unanticipated floods, unexpected droughts, and rise into prominence by unseasonal pests and diseases shake our farming front. It will make our farmers more vulnerable than already they are. The situation should prompt us to think of and work for better farming practices, water management techniques, flooded tolerant and weather resilient crop varieties. A special directorate is intended to establish for enhancing efficiency in the production of seeds and planting materials and the distribution of the same to the farmers in accordance with the policy statement of Government of Kerala. Projects are planned for development of breeding technology for equipping vegetable crops to overcome adverse conditions through an establishment of a center of excellence in tropical vegetables. Mapping of the value chain of the mango in Mudalavada, Palakkad is proposed to be done in a comprehensive manner. Production of biofertilizers and biopesticides will be enhanced. Mobile apps will be developed for easy dissemination of agricultural information to the farmers to promote organic agriculture. A lead center is also aimed to be established. And the moral demonstration form, more than 30 across the state are going to be established. KA is a frontline partner in all the initiative of Kerala state, especially the recent Kerala Knowledge Economy Mission. And in the human resource front, Kerala Agricultural University recently appointed more than 240 young meritorious assistant professors across all the units in the state. And more than 90 of our faculty have got promoted through career advanced promotions recently. And nearly 300 casual labors have been appointed through a meritorious and transparent selection process. Contribution of these additional human resources, I am sure, will reflect in taking the KAU to greater heights in the next 3 to 5 years. And as we all know, the recent objective of the government of Kerala to increase productivity, profitability and sustainability in our agriculture. That is the goal and objective of agricultural development for the state for the next 5 years. And the government of Kerala has greater trust in the scientists of Kerala Agriculture University, community of Kerala Agriculture University. They are told all the technology of Kerala Agriculture University will be taken and disseminated to the farming community for achieving these triple goals. Similarly, the vegetable production has to be doubled. Nursery, you know, that should be a separate law is going to be formed for ensuring the quality of planting materials in the state. So these objectives of the government of Kerala and the expectations of the community, especially farmers, students and all other stakeholders, we can be met only when the community of Kerala Agricultural University rededicate ourselves to the service, of the farming community, students and all other stakeholders. While we stand on the soil with a sense of liberty and hope, let us remember who ensured that to us. Let us salute the young, disciplined, fervent officers of defense forces who toil day and night, brave the ice cold and extreme desert heat, sacrifice their entire lives so the rest of us enjoy the fruits of freedom. We owe to them, to the builders of this nation, the protectors of this nation and the fighters for this nation. Equally important, the sweat and sacrifices of our farming fraternity in producing food for millions, even among perpetuating uncertainties in weather, pest and diseases, price and even pandemic. We owe to the farming fraternity every day and every minute. Being an agricultural university, it is also our primary responsibility to direct every activity of ours to the upliftment of farmers, students and stakeholders. Let us celebrate our independence with responsibility, humility, awareness and above all, a love for this country. Let us all unite in protecting our solidarity with everything we have. Jai Hind. Thank you. I think it is needless to emphasize the dedicated sacrifices made by our health workers during the last couple of years in protecting our citizens in the state and across the country from this dreaded pandemic. And I am sure all of us might have experienced their service through various clinics, especially in the primary health clinic in our Vellanikara campus. We always owe to these doctors, medical professionals, health workers, and also police, their personnel and our colleagues in the Department of Police for ensuring a safe and a secure life free from this pandemic. So during this August vacation, we want to felicitate our health workers from Community Health Center Vellanikara, Dr. Jayanti. She has completed 25 years of service and 4 years from Community Health Center Vellanikara. Manju Mol, pharmacist, 8 years of service in Community Health Center Vellanikara. Surya, lab technician, 5 years service in the Community Health Center Vellanikara. We all let us actually appreciate them for their actually committed and dedicated service, leaving their family back home and working for the welfare and safety of the rest of the citizens in the state during weekends and during hard hours. And